We live in an era of information at your fingertips that you could just do another search.
I'm sure some misinformation is probably spread on both sides.
First things first, see who said it or who published it.
Misinformation, it's all around us. Let's talk about it. February 2020. The U.S. Surgeon General, government leaders, and science professionals were all giving us the same information. Everyday Americans did not need to wear a mask to protect ourselves from the COVID-19 virus.
The average American does not need to go out and buy a mask.
But by the summer, the CDC and federal officials reversed their stance. Everybody should wear a mask.
When you are not able to socially distance, wear a mask. Whether you like the mask or not, they have an impact.
The new information seemed to contradict the original message.
Were we all just playing a global game of telephone?
Hey there, I'm Alex Clark. I'm a journalist, instructor of video, and a filmmaker. And with Nova Science Studio, we're going to be breaking down misinformation. Misinformation is shared millions of times a day on Facebook alone, so it's easy to get tangled up. So at first, we're told that masks are not necessary, and then many areas are requiring people to wear them. By the summer of 2020, people in all 50 states are wearing masks as part of their everyday attire. I got my keys, wallet, mask, I'm good to go. But thousands of people remain convinced that masks were not effective. And many of the people who did not believe in masks relied on social media as their primary source of science information. And there is a lot of misinformation out there, some of which was very convincing. There were even fake notices from the CDC advising that people should not wear masks, which is wild. All of this had a very real effect. A model from the Institute of Health Metrics at the University of Washington found that if 95% of Americans had worn masks starting in mid-June, there would have been nearly 22,000 fewer deaths by the 1st of October. So yes, the stakes are high when it comes to spotting misinformation. By the way, science misinformation is defined as a statement that contradicts what established science tells us to be true. We're all prone to believe many of these messages as part of our human nature. But don't take it from me. Dominique Brassard is an expert on science misinformation. And she points out that often people share misinformation only because it aligns with their worldview.
We rely on mental shortcuts to help us make sense of the world around us, relying on those beliefs that are very important to us. Religious beliefs and things that, you know, our church tell us, environmental worldviews, we think the environment is really something we should protect.
In the case of somebody who doesn't believe in climate change, it doesn't matter if, say, 97% of scientists say it's real, because it doesn't align with what they've already ingrained in their thinking.
Exactly. If something really doesn't align with your political views, you're going to discard it. Another reason why people may actually believe information or share information online very quickly is because it's information that gives them hope. So an example that actually, you know, pertain to this is anything related to health.
I think I know what she means. When you look today on Instagram, there's products that boost your metabolism, make you thinner, give you more energy. But the problem is that these facts often aren't verified and we don't have information about who's pushing them. But the FTC took on social influencers in 2019. They fined a company called Teamy, whose ad said that their products not only promoted weight loss, but also fought cancer. Teamy! Today, the FTC advises users use hashtags like these to let you know that it's sponsored information. One last reason people believe false information when it occurs is that the content is just funny or satirical.
People may share things because it thinks they're funny. And this is something that we've seen with young audience as well, with the memes and so on.
Some users might even use the humor to justify sharing the misinformation.
At the end of the day, it was just a joke. And a joke taken out of context can be perceived as reality.
What's important about all these cases, whether it's funny, whether it aligns with your worldview, is it doesn't always matter why somebody shared it. Whether it was intentional or not, it's altering our perception of reality. So thinking back to the Coronavirus Task Force recommendation, what to make of it?
The average American does not need to go out and buy a mask.
We were told early on that we shouldn't wear masks, and now we are told that we should wear masks may seem contradictory.
The discovery of asymptomatic spread is one of the reasons the scientific advice changed. It's defined as the transmission of a disease via individuals who do not exhibit symptoms.
This whole concept of asymptomatic spread elevated the need for mask wearing by the general public. But there's more. By the summer, we learned that there was no longer a threat of a widespread shortage of personal protective equipment, or PPE, and even some homemade masks could be partly effective in stopping the airborne transmission. Therefore, masks became a no-brainer. Everybody should wear one.
So let's recap. These are some of the reasons that people believe in misinformation. First,
it could be because our understanding of the science on the topic has changed. Or it could be because misinformation has simply affirmed our existing beliefs. And in some cases, it's just because it's funny and we want to share it with other people. So now, how does it spread? That's next episode.